I wrote Pop Goes the World originally as an instrumental. I was trying to get something like popcorn or that type of sort of like wacky instrumental, electronic instrumental song going. And I wrote the song along with 10 or 12 other songs, and I just tagged it on the end of the demo as a little kind of instrumental hook. Sent the demo off to Derek Schulman, who was the A&R guy at Polygram in New York. Derek Schulman was also the lead singer of the prog rock band Gentle Giant. And I sent him the demo, 12 songs and this little instrumental riff at the end. And he phoned me and he said, okay. He says, what I want you to do is I want you to take that little instrumental song, that little 2-minute riff at the end, and I want you to write a song like that. A whole song around it. I want you to put lyrics on it and make a real song out of it. And then I wanted you to take those 10, 12 other songs that you wrote and throw those away. And I want you to write 10 more like that Pop Goes the World song that you wrote. And I was like, what? But he was like one of my heroes. He was one of, you know, my prog rock heroes. And he had also been in a band with his brothers. He was the lead vocalist. He might know what he's talking about. And so that's what I did. I went back into studio and spent quite a while building a song, writing. It was actually one of the first songs that I actually sat down and worked on and wrote as a song, and tried to write 10 more like it, and put the album together and put it out, and this is what happened. And no, it was good advice. It was great advice. It's advice that I give now, that I give to young musicians, is sometimes you have to put your art in your back pocket and listen to people who like Derek, who knew what they were talking about. And it's sometimes a question of pride, but in my case, it turned out pretty good. Turned out good for me anyway. It was good. Video was also really important. It was done by Tim Pope, who had also done the Safety Dance video. And we tried to incorporate a lot of our Quebec roots in it with the Bonhomme Carnaval and everything, and got a lot of stares from the border guards walking into different countries with the Bonhomme head under our arm. But it was all in good fun. I introduced the song live also, is another thing. I introduced the song as the song that I wrote the year that Rachel Ashmore, one of our keyboard players, was born. So that's another fun fact.